Good evening. Welcome to .programming.blogspot.com. In previous video tutorials, we have already learned about how to get data from database using edmx file. Today I'm talking about insert data into database using edmx file. So the same procedure to load the edmx file in Solution Explorer. So first of all, add edmx file into your project. So in the default, in my Solution Explorer, add a new item, ad.net entity data model. Rename it with the one. Edit. Oops. Database 1.df file. SQL server file. The name of the server is Jacob. Test connection successfully added. And now change your database connection string with the newer connection string, in which we have the name of the database is DB, but in the connection strings we have application data and database.md files. Select table, click to finish. Take some time to add model in the Solution Explorer. So wait for some times. Actually, in edmx models we have two file. That is, the first one is the context class, that is the business logic code, and the second one is the model class. Here we have a classes, or you can say the entities of the project. So here we have user table, in which three properties, that is ID, username and passwords. Now first of all go to the context class. Okay, now select the model class, that is user table, in which we have three properties, that is ID, username and passwords. Now if you want to add item by using the some text boxes, or you can say the input controls. So first of all add input controls and decorate the web forms. Password, you can also use some validations for validate the form. But in this example I will not use those validations. uh, It's a simple login form, or you can say it's a simple registration form actually, because in this tutorials we will add items into the databases. So select the context class, that is the DB entities. So first of all, create a instance of the context class DB entities, DBE equals to new DB entities. Yeah, DBE. In I have a single table for I have a single model table, that is user table. TR equals to new user table. User table in the model we have only single model, that is user table. Sorry, equals to new user table. That is the single model class in EDMX file. So add some value into the properties, the model class, that is tr.username. Value comes from the input text boxes, so text box 1.text, tr.password equals to text box 2.text. It's too much easy if you compare this code with other data other techniques like ad.net and record sets. db.usertables.add, db.saveChanges, it's a simple method to changes, or you can say updations, in the database table. So add this user table instance in the user table context. Now check. Thank you very much for watching this video tutorial. Please keep watching my all video tutorials which is related to ASP.NET and entity framework. I will not use the hard and fast rules. We always use easy and simple techniques to get data and insert data into databases, and any other functions which is provided some functionalities of databases. So thank you very much for watching this video tutorials again. Thank you.